Hey everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario Land. I'm Duke of the Bump. So, we had a pretty good run yesterday, made it through World 1 without losing any lives. Only got hit once, I think, which was pretty good. So I was talking yesterday about how this game kind of gets a lot of flack these days. I mean, I like this game. It feels fine. The only thing I didn't like about it was how short it was. I guess that's what it gets flack for. Huh. I was wondering if there was a way to, like, infinitely hit that and get points and get a 1-up, but it didn't look like it. And just a butt ton of coins up here. So yeah, this game came out in 1989, which was, I think, the year after Super Mario 3. I believe that was 88. I don't know. I could be wrong. So, I guess for anyone who played Mario 3, obviously, this is a gigantic step back. I mean, we're back to Mario 1 levels of sophistication. Just one power-up. You can't scroll the screen backwards. Not nearly as much stuff to do in this game. But, I mean, you know, it's a handheld system, so it's going to be a smaller scale. But see, that's why I'm interested in exploring more of the Mario Land series, because from what I understand, this game gets pretty, or the series gets pretty, the games get pretty big. I was listening to a podcast called Retronauts, and it's a cool podcast where cool people talk about old games, and a couple months ago they had, they had an episode all about the Wario series, and that's kind of what made me want to go back and explore some of these older games, because they talked about the Wario games with a lot of fondness. I guess fire doesn't work on anything that comes from the sea, because I can't kill those fish either. It's weird. Oh god. Whew, that was close. So yeah, I'm actually really looking forward to, I played through a little bit of Mario Land 2 years later on an emulator. I never finished that one, but it seemed pretty cool from what I played of it. So yeah, I'm quite excited to have a look at the rest of the series. Not sure how many games there are. I think Wario Land 4 for the Game Boy Advance was the last proper Wario game. Or the last numbered Wario Land game. And then there's that Master of Disguise game. Oh! Damn, lost her first life. There was that Master of Disguise game for the Wii. And from what I hear, that game was not great. I think there was another Wario game on the Wii that I'm forgetting. So, yeah, I won't be able to play those games, but, you know, the actual numbered canonical Wario games, I should be able to play through all of those. Okay, well, we lost a life, but that wasn't too bad. Yeah, the Wario games get really weird. Just listening to them talk about it on Retronauts made it sound quite a bit different from what one would normally expect from a Mario game. Alright. I mean, so far, this has been pretty similar to Super Mario Brothers for the NES. I mean, there are stylistic differences, of course, because you have to, you have to fit everything onto the Game Boy. And B, I'm pretty sure this is made by a completely different team from any of the Super Mario Brothers games. So, I guess they put their own little touches onto it. Like, your projectile can collect coins. What's up with that? I mean, it's a good idea. And I assume that only having one projectile on the screen at a time is a technical choice, because they didn't want to have too many of those bouncing around and slowing the game down. I think that weird crunching noise a little bit ago was slowdown, because there's a lot of stuff on the screen at the time. Those clouds look like Mario clouds. That's definitely a callback. Oh crap! The physics, I don't know. They're okay. They're not great. It feels kind of like someone tried to make a Mario game in Game Maker, and it's just not quite right. I mean, nothing against Game Maker. There are some cool Game Maker games, but whoa! Oh man, you can't jump on the exposed half of the robot. That's something I never thought I'd say about a Mario game. Oh, now I know. Oh god. Like, flew. Damn it. I don't think I'm going to be able to get that star. I've died twice trying to get it instead of just making... Well, maybe if I just... If it didn't take so long. If it didn't, like, fly up off the top of the screen like that, I would have been able to get it... Whoa! I didn't think it would get that close to me. Okay, well, maybe this game isn't as easy as I remember. I mean, I'm just making dumb mistakes now. Like, see, there I go again. Getting focused on that star to my own detriment. Whoa! That's cool. I'll get big. Thanks, game. I appreciate the opportunity you presented me to become a larger version of myself. Alright, I doubt I can jump on those things if I couldn't fire blast them, so. Oh, it just regenerates its head? Whoa, that's so weird. Piranha plants remind me of something out of a Metroid game. It reminds me of those things that cling to the ceiling and like kind of spiral down towards Samus. Or Samus. Is it Samus or Samus? I've heard it both ways. Pretty sure it's supposed to be Samus. Alright, Invisiblock, there you are. See, it's kind of cool that this is actually different than the last one. They put a little bit of effort into it, which I appreciate. I'm impressed with the music so far, I have to say. That was one way the Game Boy was infinitely superior to the Game Gear, was the music. Game Gear, I mean, it was just a Master System, and the Master System itself had some pretty god-awful music, and the Game Gear was no better. Go look up the music for Tasmania on the Game Gear sometime. It'll blow your mind. Alright. So I'm pretty sure that, whoa! Oh yeah! Wow, I totally forgot about this part. I mean, I remember it now that I see it, but... Man, this is so weird! Now this is different than anything in a Mario game up to this point. First Mario game to feature vehicles, I believe. What's with all the UFOs? The whole submarine just shrinks. That's awesome. So if you hold down the button, you get like a rapid fire. So I should probably do that instead of pumping it. Which is what I was doing. Okay, if you hold down the A button, it's rapid fire. If you press the B button, it's just a single shot. Interesting. Of course, if you mash it, it's a little faster than the normal rapid fire shot. M. Oh, there's that robot noise again. A-R-I-O. What's that spell? All together now. Mario. Unless you're Canadian. If you're Canadian, then it's Mario. Oh, man. It's like the predecessor to the Wario noise that thing makes. Oh man, the crazy sinister music is playing even though I killed the boss. I could have just like gone under him and made it to the exit without having to actually kill him. Is that a submarine or like a suit with a propeller on it? Because it has like the buttons in the normal spot. Or is that just like... That might have just been Mario inside the thing. Like the whole thing was transparent. Oh no! She turned into a four-legged jumping octopus. Alright. Well, that went pretty well. I forget if I have a fire flower or not. Two extra lives. That's pretty good. Alright, well, back to this music. That'll do it for this edition of Let's Play Super Mario Land. Tune in tomorrow for World 3. See you later.